so many beautiful things that have come up. Some shows, some beautiful costumes and stuff. What was like your inspiration for setting up this company?
New York. It's a New York show. It's not Nadia's a New York woman. Yeah. All of our women on the show are New York women, and everyone lives in New York. We don't know this necessarily where they came from originally,
right,
but
right.
That was really part of it, is pulling in the reality of New York to this fictional world that we're creating that is about New York.
Right.
And then the characters themselves, because they're all so different.
Right.
Nadia's very matter-of-fact. Yeah. Maxine is very not matter-of-fact. Lizzie is very into her art and her very cool vibe. And so that was really important that we get that information across visual clothes.
Right. Oh my God, that's great. Now, is there one particular thing that's challenging for you when you're creating it? Scheduling? Is it budget?
Oh, it's always all of that stuff.
Yeah, of
with this one, it was actually the limit. We never limited them. Costumes for the characters, because it was
right.
The same costume for most of the characters for most of the season.
Mm-hmm.
And so we really wanted to get that right.
Right.
Make sure that the pieces were all there, that they were functional. There's a lot of stunt work in the show, that the actors were comfortable being there for such a long time.
Right.
Because it's one of those things where it creates the costume. In this case,
yeah.
It was 8 episodes,
right.
Same thing. Or it was uncomfortable and not working.
Right.
And those are all practical concerns, but creatively, I wanted it to not get boring.
Right.
And hopefully all the different layers that are in the costumes help with that. I mean, there's always something different to look at.
Yeah.
Maxine's million necklaces, or you know, got all the layers and how she breaks them apart and takes them off and adds
yeah.
them back on in various points in the story. Definitely a lot for this one, especially for Russian Doll, a lot on the street. And then for every show that I do for its own
character.
And so we use a lot of street stuff imagery or photos of real people in New York at various locations. So museum openings or art openings or things that would be relevant to what we were doing. And a lot of Instagram. I think a variety of things on Instagram.
Right.
Food, flowers, and carpentry, and jewelry, so a real mishmash.
Right.
And so that actually was a lot of useful references in the breadth of the account.
Is there one particular TV show, movie, or something that made you like?
I do also find that rather compelling.
I don't know if
that's
yeah. directly linked to my getting into the business, but it's
right.
definitely linked to my love of storytelling and escaping into a different world.
Yeah.
And it's this tiny story that did insanely well back in the 80s.
Right.
And you know, it's about horses. And it's time period, and
right.
just, I remember watching that when I was younger, and that it was completely cool. You really just sort of step out of the world and watch that for an hour and a half, 2 hours, be completely entertaining. And then growing up, my mom or grandmother's thing also knitted or quilted, or, so it was very built in.
Right.
So, and the combination of those two things was very powerful when I actually figured out what I did.
Yeah, that is great. And so, like,
when
you're at
this,
I love
this event. There's
so many, like, great
things
to see.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How
do
you feel when you find out
that
you're
a brand
interior?
I'm so excited.
Yeah.
And I've been very fortunate to have been invited to one or two other times
mm-hmm.
with costumes from girls and extras from Nash. So to get invited
right.
again,
right.
just, it's kind of a huge honor for costumes and in general, but to be in such a next to Pose, and that's just mind blowing to me because the shows that I've watched that I've
right,
watched
right.
and to see those other Pose and personal, I'm already a huge fan. It's,
right.
just, it's so gratifying to be able to look at those in person and think, wow, I watched them on television
right.
and I get to see it in life. And I only hope that that's true of my show as well.
Oh my God, that's great. And is there anything outside of Russian Girl that you're working on?
Well, Orange is the New Black just streamed its final season a couple of weeks ago. So it's streaming now, and that was a different show again for season 7. And there are so many more costumes in this season that it was really excited to go back to a show that you know that you love, that you already work so closely with the cast, the producers, and directors, and have it be a really good challenge. And I've never been on a project. Everything is both so comfortable and so beautiful all at the same time. And then I am working on a new series that's just going into production at the moment now. So we're just getting our people to see how it goes.
Great. And then, like, what else is the question?
Oh, of course.
It's become a pop culture phenomenon. We talk about it. Did we that saying? Everything has to be part of something that will be remembered long after off the air.
I'm speechless. I don't even have any words because the feelings are so big, especially since it's done.
Yeah.
I'm sure this is family, and I know everyone on this says that, and it's because it's true. I met people on that show that I never would have otherwise met, but behind the scenes, I have on the camera, and I have a bunch of talk on the show, and it's almost less about the producing of the and that it's having such resonance over all the seasons that we've been having and changing our television.
Yeah.
In so many ways,
I know.
It's not very often you get to publish something
that helps create streaming.
That really helps you to shift the conversation and has such an impact on such an audience.
Yeah.
And that's a great reason to talk to it. Thank you so much. Fingers crossed, it's great. Thank you.
Yeah.